Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can calculate sum of major as well as minor diagonal of a matrix. So I will be implementing the solution in C language. And before start, I just want to share one information. If you go to detail or description of this video, you will find links of various playlists related to C language. So you can watch various programs related to C on those playlists. So do watch them. Now, first I'm going to tell you the logic through which we can calculate sum of major and minor diagonals, and then I will be writing the program. So let's say this is a 3x3 matrix. These are the indexes. So row index 0, 1, 2, as well as column indexes 0, 1, 2. And these are the values. So these 9 values are available in the matrix. So if I want to add all these values, 1, 5, and 9, so this will be called as major diagonal. This is major diagonal. And if I want to add these values, 3, 5, and 7, so this is called as minor diagonal, right? So I will tell you how you can calculate sum of both the diagonals with a single C program. So now I am going to write the solution for you. So first of all, I am going to declare a 2D array. Then two variables ij for loop rotation. Then s1 equals to 0 and s2 equals to 0. So S1 will be having sum of major diagonal and S2 will be having sum of minor diagonal. Now a printf which will display the message enter 3x3 matrix, and after this I am going to repeat two loops, one for rows and one for columns. So these are two loops, and these loops will be reading values from user. Right? So till here program is very simple. We just written the code through which we can read values from the user. Now I am going to write the logic. So first I am going to write the logic for adding major diagonal. So if we identify the indexes of major diagonal values, so 1, 5, and 9. So if we see the index, so they are 0, 0, 1, 1, and 2, 2. 0, 0, 1, 1, and 2, 2. It means if row and column indexes are same, then we have the value for major index, right? And if I talk about minor index, if I talk about the value for minor index, so here it is 3, 5, and 7. So if we see the index of 3, it is 0 and 2. Then for 5, it is 1, 1, and for 7, it is 2, 0. So here, what is the logic? If we add both, if we put plus here, so it will be 2 always. So it means in your matrix, if you have 3 rows or 3 columns, then you need to check some of those indexes which are available on a minor diagonal position. If they are equal to row size or column size minus 1, then you can add those values as minor diagonal, right? And if you see other indexes like this 0 0 1 0 1, then for 4 it is 1 0, for 8 it is 2 3, for 9 it is 2 2, for 6 it is 1 2. So if you see other values, then their indexes are not making 2, right? So now I'm going to write the logic. So this is first loop, then I'm writing second loop. So this is jth second loop, nested loop. Now inside this you can write if I double equals to j. So if I and j both are equal, it means we are talking about major diagonal. So here we can write S1 equals to S1 plus A of ij. Right? So if both the indexes are equal, then only this value will be added to S1. So it means we are calculating major diagonal sum. Now, if I plus j double equals to 2, if I plus j double equals to 2, then this will be having those values which are on minor diagonal positions. Now remember that here we have dimensions at S 3 by 3. If you have dimension as 4 by 4, 5 by 5, then you will see the sum of minor diagonal values indexes will be row or column size minus 1 always. So if you have 4 by 4 matrix, then this sum will be 3. The sum of those values which are on minor diagonal position, their indexes sum will be 3 in case of 4 by 4 matrix, right? In case of 5 by 5 matrix, their sum will be 4. So this way you can easily identify, like we have 3 by 3 dimension, so that's why ij sum should be equal to 2. If it is so, then we can add value of ij into S2. So first if is for main diagonal, that is major diagonal. Second if for minor diagonal. So here two different logics are implemented. Now I can close this loop and close this loop, right? And after closing this loop, I can write sum of major diagonal equals to percent d, sum of minor diagonal equals to percent d, then S1 comma S2. And then I can complete the main function. So this way I have implemented the complete solution in front of you. I explained you the logic for major diagonal indexes, for minor diagonal indexes. So this way you can understand, like, how you don't need to remember the whole program, you just need to remember this logic. So how we can identify a common logic for major diagonal position indexes, so they will be equal for rows and column, and for minor, diagonal positions, you just need to add both the indexes I and j. If their sum is equals to, sorry, if their sum is equals to a row or column size minus 1, then the value is available on minor diagonal position, right? So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video, and try to implement this in your system so that you can verify and test whether the code is implemented correctly or not. And if you want to watch more programming related videos, open my channel, go to playlist, or you can go to detail or description of this video where you can find links of various playlists related to C programming. So I hope you understood whatever I explained. Thank you for watching this video.